So how are you guys involved in this event?
Well, we received a call about 2 weeks ago from Pastor Charles Allen and Bishop Parker, who wanted to get a group of faith leaders together in a room to say what is going to be our response to the George Floyd situation, but not only to the George Floyd situation, but to all of these things, these injustices that have been going on. So we met on a Sunday afternoon 2 weeks ago, a group of pastors in a room and on Zoom, and we called the mayor in, and it just grew from there. A week later, we had the march last week, Faith Leaders United March, yes. And today we have the women here doing what we what is named a pray test.
Yes. Yes, and so from that, from the group, the Faith Leaders United for Change, we have also, as you heard Lady Mac say, we are birthing another sub-ministry coming from that called the 419 Women Rise Up. So we are going to take a stand also, and we're going to be getting together soon this week and putting together some seminars and other things that we can do to continue to be active as women as a part of Faith Leaders United for Change.
So how are you guys both personally affected by what happened to George Floyd?
I think as mothers.
Yeah, I am a mother of a 26-year-old black son who recently moved to Atlanta. I only have one child. I cannot imagine if his life was taken at the hands of cruel police brutality or hatred or racism or anything like that. I've always taught him, as you heard the other mother say, taught him to do well. If you do well and work hard, you can be whatever you want to be. And now I feel like it's almost like you can be everything you want to be, just don't be black.
And for myself, being the mother of three sons, you teach your sons, make sure that you have your driver's license, make sure that you have insurance, make sure that you pull over and that you answer any questions that the police may have. And now we're finding that that's not enough. We teach our children to be recognize authority, but authority isn't recognizing our children as men. And so that's why this is personal to us.
So what change do you guys hope to make?
Primary changes, we want to see a change between relationship between leadership, the citizens of Toledo, and the police. We want the police to be as accountable for their actions as we are. We're taking our actions seriously, but we want them to take their actions seriously. I can't go to my job and do something that goes against the company's morals or values or their policies without facing some kind of discipline, yet we have a justice system that's set up to protect those that's supposed to protect us. And so we're hoping to see the change primarily there.
And I agree. And I also want to add to that, having the police be more involved in our community. Growing up as a child, I remember seeing the police ride down the street. We were never fearful. I don't know when that transition happened where, you know, you're afraid or anxious or nervous when you see the police. Even if you have a good record, just being black and seeing them behind you just makes you nervous. So just having them more boots on the ground instead of just being behind the steering wheel all the time and creating that fearful environment for the black community.